Hello friends, today we will be discussing on the topic project planning. I am Satish Pariyani, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to use significance of project planning process. Content. The three parts what we will cover is overview of project planning, purpose of project planning process. Basics. After the project has been defined and the project team has been appointed, you are ready to enter the second phase in the project management life cycle, that is the detailed project planning phase. The project planning phase is often the most challenging phase for the project manager, as you need to make an educated guess about the staff, resources, equipment needed to complete your project. Also, in this, why it is supposed to be the most challenging is because of communication. We have not only to deal with the internal, our staff people, the external affairs, the government policies, and many times the vendors or third party people. So the communication plays a vital role in the project planning phase. Purpose of project planning. The primary purpose is to establish the business requirements. Second, to establish the cost, schedule, list of deliverables and delivery dates. Means after establishing the business requirements, suppose, then we have to need to go to the cost. What will be the cost associated during this project? What is the timeline or the schedule? And what are our deliverables? Many times we see key what happens, especially in the software type of project planning, key we want a fast system, suppose a client says. Now that has to be converted very exactly how much fast, whether the speed required will be 10 Mbps, 100 Mbps, 200 Mbps, something in this way. So we need to take out or list down very correctly what does the deliverable are. Many times the customer or even our top bosses deliver in quantifiable manner. So exactly what is to be delivered, and secondly when is to be delivered, means delivery dates. Many times if the project is, even if it is cheap and if it runs for longer durations, means it will be not acceptable because the deadline has to be met. The third is establish the resource plans. In project planning phase, we need to consider this as a very important step, because resources, not only the primary resources, but we need to make some alternative plan or alternate resource plan or alternative resources has to be established, because if primary resource fails, then our the remaining project should not get hampered. So alternate always should be developed. In this type, generally we should avoid the monopoly. Monopoly may be in terms of vendors, monopoly in may be in terms of typically skill in the person. So we need to avoid such kind of monopoly. So resources plan, whether it is man, material or methods, we need to, if material is there, whether we are able to take it from two different suppliers, or man, whether the alternate person is there, suppose he becomes ill or he falls sick or something, accident happens, something like that, which is factor which is beyond our control. So this kind of things we need to, and third, also many times we need to plan certain buffer. Then we need to obtain the management approval regarding all this about parts and proceed to the next phase. Now we'll discuss project planning process in depth. First we'll define the scope planning. specifying the in-scope requirements for the project to facilitate creating the work breakdown structure. Many times, project is of complex nature, so we need to break down into different tasks. So the big part with the scope has to be defined very clearly, and that has to be divided or break down into the structure. Preparation of work breakdown structure. Spelling out the breakdown for the project into task and subtask. Suppose, let us consider now example. Suppose we need to build the road 6 kilometers. So we need to break down within first kilometer, second kilometer. Then in that first kilometer, we need to break down into 100 meters, what is required. Then second 100 meters, something like that. We need to happen, make it very clearly, and somebody has to be assigned to that work. So preparation of work breakdown structure is far, far important in this project planning process. Then comes the project schedule development. Now we have major project. Now we have defined the task 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what are the task and subtask in that. Then listing the entire schedule of activities and detailing the sequence of implementation. As I told you, this 100 meters in before case, 100 meters when it is to be completed, who will be doing that, very clearly exact dates need to be put it in, so that we, when whether we are moving away or towards the project, is to be very clearly identified and proper action need to be taken in that way. Then comes the resource planning. In resource planning, indicating who will do that work, at what time, which time, and in which special skills are required to accomplish the project. In this, now material is required, material planning is to be done. As I told you during the basic part, ki material planning has to be done, which proper manpower planning has to be done. We need not depend on the monopoly. Monopoly will kill many times the project. But parallelly, we also need to understand whether the skilled person or skilled type of resources have to be made altered without hampering the quality of project. So very clearly resource planning has to be done, alternative resource or buffers had to be maintained for material and manpower. Budget planning. This is the very, very important step in project planning process, specifying the budgeted cost to be incurred at the completion of the project. We need to plan at what will be the tentative cost or the cost associated when we'll complete the project, so that our management or stakeholders should be very clearly that project is being done at this much of cost. Procurement planning, focusing on vendors outside your company and subcontracting. Many times it happens that the process which we are making in-house can be made cheaper by subcontracting. But by making subcontracting, we are inviting more external factors into us, because we need to control the vendor part or vendor quality, something like that, which are easily controllable when we are doing within our company. But we need to take certain decisions based on cost, quality, so that how our vendor is reliable, on that basis whether procurement planning or procurement of process, procurement of material need to be very clearly done. Risk management. Planning for possible risk and considering optional contingency plan and mitigation strategy. Without risk, nothing can be done. So there has to be risk in the project. There will be risk in the project. There has to be certain buffers or certain planning part which is associated need to be done for planning. Planning for risk and considering optional contingency plan and mitigation strategy. Quality planning, assessing quality criteria to be used for the project, whether it is in-house or external people or for the people. for the material. Then communication planning, designing a communication strategy with all the project stakeholder. Whether nowadays specific many times we are using Google as a source, mail not only I will say, but downloading part or Google themes which we are using. So different types of strategies can be used. Many times visual strategies also can be used. It depends on type of project and the extent of project. Now users will often being describing their objectives in qualitative language. As I told you in the previous slides also, the project manager must work with the user to provide quantifiable definitions to those qualitative terms. These quantifiable criteria include schedule, cost and quality measures. Let us see with one example. A web user may ask for fast system. The quantitative requirement should be all screens must load under 3 seconds. Describe the time limit during which the screen must load is specific and tangible. For that reason, you will know that the requirement has been successfully completed when the objective has been met. Now think. The main purpose of work breakdown structure is to reduce complicated activities into collection of tasks, whether the above statement is true or false. Work breakdown structure. Yes, the answer is true, because this is important for the project manager, because he or she can oversee the task more efficiently than those complex activities. Tasks must be measurable and independent with clarity, clearly defined limits. Now the references used are from NPTEL, wiki.com and the book Project Management and Control, Narendra Singh, Himalaya Publication House. Thank you.